Hey, this is Ralph, and in this video I want to go over some of the problems you might face if you use an image that has too big of a file size. Now I'm going to go ahead and launch this page here called Image Element, and when I do so I want you to keep your eye focused on the image over here on the right while still getting an overview of the web page, because it's going to go kind of quick here. So I'm going to go and click on this, but look over in the right side. There you go, watch how that image slowly downloads. Okay, so this is illustrating actually a pretty common problem. When you take that photo with your camera, but the file size of this image is pretty big, it's almost 3 megabytes. I think it's about 2.7 megabytes. I'll verify that in just a second. But because this image file size is so big, you saw how slow it was to download. And by the way, I'm on a high-speed internet connection at my school. So that is problematic. You might say, oh, what's really the big deal? I mean, it was slow, but it was still just in a matter of seconds. You might think, well, I don't have a lot of users that use dial-up connections, so I'm not too concerned about that. But a lot of your users are using smartphones and tablets, and if they are using a Wi-Fi connection, or if they are using even more expensive, a cellular connection, this slow image is really going to eat up their data usage. The other thing is, there's no real benefit to this. There's no benefit to me displaying a 2.7 megabyte image here when a small 100 kilobyte image would have worked just fine, because I've got the image scaled down visually. So basically there's no upside to me using this high quality image, and it's an easy mistake to make, because you get those images off your point-and-shoot cameras, they default to 3 megabytes, 4 megabytes, 5 megabytes in size, and without any editing you want to put them out on the web page. So this is a problem you need to solve, and one of the best ways to do that is with some basic image editing, and make sure you have an image that's optimized file size wise for the web page. So that really large image that I just used, and it's way too big for its purpose, is this Lassen Big picture right here. And you can see it's almost 2.8 megabytes in size, 2700 kilobytes. And that is just, it's just too large. Now, if you do want to provide your users the large version image, you know, maybe they want to use desktop wallpaper, you want them to see the original, that's no problem. But if it's really just to display an image on a web page, like in my example here, there's no need to have an almost 3 megabyte image for this. So I'm going to use a basic little image editor here, Pixlr, and I'll go ahead and open image from my computer so that I can scale this down a little bit. And you don't have to be a Photoshop expert to use that. At the very least, if you're a web developer, you really just need to be able to do a few things, you know, crop, resave, maybe do a little bit of color correction and stuff like that. But you want to get these images down to a more manageable size, especially keeping their purpose in mind and the users in mind. Big images take up a lot of bandwidth, take up a lot of data usage. All right, so I've got this image here. It's almost 3 megabytes in size, and I just want to do a couple quick things to it. I don't want to crop, I don't want to recolor. Really just resizing is probably going to be the fastest way for you to really see the difference. So I'll jump up here to image, and I'll go to image size. And I can see it's this original image is 4,000 by 3,000 pixels. No need to keep it that big. So I'm gonna drop this down. We got a little slide rule here. I'll drop it all the way down to 400 by 300. 400 by 300 pixels. And I'll click OK. Oh wow, it looks pretty tiny there, right? But don't forget I'm zoomed out to like 17%. I can bring this up to 100%, and now we can see the image in a slightly better, more realistic way. So now I've got this image resized, so now I just want to go ahead and save it. So I'll click on File and Save, and it's going to default to my computer, and actually, that's fine. It does give me some options to put up onto Facebook, Flickr, or Picasa. I'm going to change its file name, though, so we can do a comparison. This will be my small version, JPEG. You can control JPEG. You can control the compression, okay? So higher quality, higher file size, lower quality, lower file size. But your picture, your image will start to look pretty crappy. I'm going to improve the quality here a bit, and I can see that it's recalculating my file size down here in the lower right corner. So now I'm just under 200 kilobytes if I go to highest quality. I think I'll do that. What the hell? So I'll click OK. And yep, it's prompting me. I'll save it in the same spot. Save. Image is now saved. So I'll go back to my file manager. We can see, all right, I had my big image, which was 2,700 kilobytes, and now I've got my small image, which is just under 160 kilobytes. So 2,700 to 159. Nice big change in file size. And since my image is going to be displayed at about 400 by 300, the end user is not going to see the difference. So let's check this out. I head over to my code, and I just change out, instead of my loss and big, I'll change this out to my loss and small image. Save this. And you notice I've got my sizing here right inside of my image tag also, width 400, height 300. So everything is saved. I head back over to my page. Now when I refresh, you're really not going to notice a change. If you got a super sharp eye, you might see a change maybe in the quality, but I doubt you will. So as I click the refresh button here, look closely at that image on the right. There you go. You didn't really see a change, but this is a smaller image. It gives the same benefit to your web visitors, but it's going to download much faster. It's going to use up less data. It's going to use up less of your visitors' data usage on their plans. It's also going to use up less of your bandwidth on your web hosting provider.